It was a hot day in the African savanna. Brother Rhinoceros did not like to be hot. He said to his friend Father Oxpecker, "Let's go to the waterhole to cool down." So off they went to the waterhole. When they arrived, Brother Rhinoceros and Father Oxpecker saw that most of the water had dried up, leaving a big patch of gooey, sticky mud. Still, the mud was cool, and Brother Rhinoceros did not like to be hot. He marched inside the mud patch, lowered his body into the ooze, rolled around a bit, and sighed happily. "Ah, perfect," he pronounced. Father Oxpecker settled in near Brother Rhinoceros's ear, picked off a fat tick, and swallowed it, and they both took a little snooze. When they woke up, Brother Rhinoceros yawned and stretched his neck. He was hungry, and it was time to eat some delicious leaves. He tried to stand up. He strained and pushed, but it was hopeless. He was completely and utterly stuck in the mud. "Don't worry, Brother Rhinoceros," Father Oxpecker exclaimed. "I'll go and find someone to help you out of this gooey, sticky mud." He flew off, promising to be back soon. After a few minutes, Father Oxpecker returned with Sister Vervet Monkey. "Perhaps I can be of assistance, for I can tie things using my fingers." She ran around the mud patch, looking for something to tie together that might help Brother Rhinoceros. But there was nothing. Father Oxpecker flew off again to fetch someone else. He returned, riding on the back of Grandfather Giraffe. Grandfather Giraffe told Brother Rhinoceros, "Perhaps I could be of assistance. After all, I am the tallest animal in the whole world." The giraffe glanced around the mud patch, but couldn't find any way that his superior height could help. Father Oxpecker soared off again to find someone else. When he returned, he was carrying Grandmother Spider on his back. Grandmother Spider said, "Perhaps I might be of assistance. I can spin silk." And she produced a delicate thread of beautiful silk from her abdomen. It fluttered in the breeze, of no help whatsoever to Brother Rhinoceros. Once again, Father Oxpecker flew off into the savanna in search of help. The ground around the mud patch started shaking and quaking. Step, stomp, step. Mother Elephant burst from the bushes with Father Oxpecker riding on her head like the captain at the helm of a ship. "Perhaps I can be of assistance," said Mother Elephant. "I am, of course, the biggest, strongest land animal in the world." But she couldn't step into the mud patch to help Brother Rhinoceros, or she would be stuck too. Her strength was no help here. Father Oxpecker dashed off yet again. He returned with Brother Weaverbird flying by his side. Brother Weaverbird declared, "Perhaps I might be of assistance, for I can weave anything. I can braid, I can knit, I can intertwine." He hopped excitedly from tree branch to tree branch, but he couldn't think of what to weave that would help Brother Rhinoceros. Everyone surrounded the mud patch, looking at each other and wondering what to do next. They were all so proud of the things they could do, but none of them could help Brother Rhinoceros out of the mud. Grandmother Spider spoke first in her sweet, gentle voice. "Okay, everyone, let's think about this. I can spin silk. Grandfather Giraffe is very tall. Brother Weaverbird can weave. Sister Vervet Monkey can tie things with her fingers. And Mother Elephant is extremely strong. Maybe we could put all of our special skills together and work as a team." Grandmother Spider started spinning long streams of silk. "Brother Weaverbird, can you weave this silk?" "Yes, yes I can," shouted Brother Weaverbird, and he used his bill to braid the silk into a long, strong rope. Brother Weaverbird asked Sister Vervet Monkey, "Will you tie this rope around Brother Rhinoceros?" "Why yes," she replied. "What a brilliant idea." She grabbed the rope and ran up to Grandfather Giraffe. "Excuse me," she said, "will you help me get over to Brother Rhinoceros?" Grandfather Giraffe nodded as Sister Vervet Monkey scrambled up his legs, over his back, up his long neck, and onto his head. Sister Vervet Monkey held onto his ossicones for support as Grandfather Giraffe bent his head down towards Brother Rhinoceros. The monkey hopped onto Brother Rhinoceros's back and tied the rope around his body. Then she scampered back across the bridge made by Grandfather Giraffe's neck, holding tightly to the other end of the rope. Sister Vervet Monkey leaped over to Mother Elephant. "Will you do the honors?" Mother Elephant beamed. She took the end of the rope into her mouth. Then the others counted. 1, 2, 3, pull! Mother Elephant took a deep breath and began to pull. And pull, and pull, and pull. The others cried out. 1, 2, 3, push! Brother Rhinoceros pushed and pushed his legs. The rope stretched and strained and quivered. Finally, with a big squishy sound, Brother Rhinoceros lifted his body up out of the mud. He carefully planted one foot in front of the other and stepped out of the oozy goo. His friends formed a circle around him and cheered.
Hooray!
Brother Rhinoceros thanked each and every one of them. Thank you, Father Oxpecker. Thank you, Grandmother Spider. Thank you, Brother Weaver Bird. Thank you, Sister Vervet Monkey. Thank you, Grandfather Giraffe. And thank you, Mother Elephant. Some of you are small and some of you are very big. You all have different special skills. Alone you couldn't help me, but each one of you contributed your special skill to save me. Together, you did it. They certainly made a great team and the best friends a muddy rhinoceros could ever have.
Thank you.